If you think you're responsible for the results of your unit or your company, then you're wrong. It's your employees, it's your team. However, what you are responsible for is the well-being of your employees, is the motivation of your employees, and it's the performance of your employees. This is what we will be talking about today. You have to make sure that you have the right employees for the right jobs, for the right tasks. How do you ensure that? And how do you motivate people who is becoming demotivated? I'm Frederick. This channel is for you. You're here because you want to grow stronger. You're here because you want to learn new skills. You're here because you want to up your leadership game. Welcome. I have 25 years of experience from all over the world in building people and businesses. And I built this channel to build you as well. Make sure that you subscribe. You will only learn from it. I promise you that. Otherwise, you can always unsubscribe. Let's figure out how we assess our employees and how you make them stronger so you can be a better performer overall. Let's go. Most likely, when you get the job as a manager or you get promoted to be a manager, then you will take over an existing team. It is in very, very rare cases that you build your own team from scratch. So what you have to do when you take over a team is you have to assess each and every team member, each and every person that are reporting directly to you, and then sometimes also people who are reporting indirectly to you. And that's not an easy job because maybe you do not know the team that well, maybe you don't know their performance, maybe you don't know the history too well. But nonetheless, this is your team, this is your unit. You're responsible for the performance. And this performance can only be made through the employees, which means that you are responsible all of a sudden for having a bunch of employees performing to their very best. That is your job. Make sure that they do so. A very simple matrix that I'm using and I've been using for many years is the will-skill matrix. It's just a 2x2 matrix where you will plot the employees after you've been talking to them, after you've been understanding what they're doing today and how they're motivated in their jobs. This requires that you speak to all your people, obviously. This requires that you know what their tasks are and what they're supposed to do and how well they're doing it. So in order to build on the will skill matrix, you need to speak with people and you need to understand their current job roles and their current performance. Besides that, I would suggest that you actually also talk to the peers of the employees. Get a second, third opinion on these people. Speak with their former management if possible, other managers from other units that are working closely with the employees. You need this holistic or 360 degree view about the employees before you can start judging them. The will skill matrix is a 2x2 matrix where you plot in the employees based on two things: their ability to perform their current job and their willingness to perform their current job. Let me say that again. So on one scale, you have these people. Would they want to work with you? Do they have a will to work or do they not have a will to work? Do they know their job? Can they do their job or can they not do their job? So this is the will. They have the will or they have not the will to work. They have the skill or they have not the skill to perform their job. You plot the people in here. Once you've done that, you look at the matrix. And for these people who are in the does not have the will, or does not have the skill, you assess, can we move them? Is it possible for me to move a does not have the will into have the will to work? And is it possible to move does not have the skill to have the skill? And this is where your job and your role comes in. This is where you have to assess your people. You have to make sure that the people who are currently not performing, they can be moved so that they can do their job and that they have the will to do their job. Only after you've tried that, and you fail, this is where you can start considering whether this person or these people, they need to look for a job somewhere else in the company or outside the company. But you owe everybody to give them that, move them from will not to will or cannot to can. And how do you do this? Let me start by the simple one, the cannot to can. Firstly, you need to make sure that they have a proper job description, a proper role description. And if they're not capable of performing into that role description, then you can create a gap analysis. You can say, okay, you're supposed to perform like this, and you're here now in these areas, and you're here now in those areas. So we have to increase your competence within this area and within that area. It's not that difficult to increase people's competences, if they have the will. I think the days where you send people to the classroom and send them away for training for a long time, I think they're over. I would suggest if you have people that you need to up-qualify, then I would suggest two things. Find an internal mentor. Find a mentor in the company that can coach them, that can train them, that can be with them. That could be you. It could be someone else. But find an internal mentor and then find some external inspiration. I would suggest looking at the online selection of courses. There is so much fantastic learning material online today. It makes no sense sending people anyway. It's too expensive, it takes too long time, and people are not capable of relating what they learned to work anyway. If you put them on an online training course together with an internal mentor, then these two will work together. The employee will have the mentor to speak with. Remember, that mentor could be you. He will have, or she will have, the mentor to speak with about what they're learning online, and they will be able to do the online learning maybe at work or at home. This is the best solution. This is how you up-qualify your people. The more difficult one, moving them from will not to will, this has to do with job motivation. And I'm gonna make another video on job motivation, because, or 10 more videos, because this is a big, big, big topic. But for now, what you have to do is to make sure that the people you're talking to, the people who does not have the will, but which you want to give the will, they must have a very, very clear job description. They must know exactly what is expected from them. One of the biggest demotivating factors is if people, they're not certain of what they're supposed to do in their job and how they're supposed to do it. And if you can lay down, this is what I expect from you, these are your job roles, and this is what it takes for you to do a good job, then they will be able to assess themselves saying, hey, I'm actually doing a good job now. And that will increase the will. Furthermore, you need to talk to them and understand, why is it that you're not motivated? What is it that is wrong? Are you not interested in your job at all? Or is your colleagues, is it me, is it something? And based on this discussion, you again have to make an action plan saying, okay, these are the things that are wrong. Let us work together on changing it. Let us work together on making these things towards what you want. Remember again, everything in leadership is about leading people, paving the way, removing the obstacles. You have to be there for them. You have to make sure that you're the one making their lives easy so that they can perform with you, for the company. This is the most important thing. You have to be the best leader possible. You cannot have any employees better than you allow them to be. You have to understand the true meaning of leadership. Leadership is showing the way, helping people, performing, helping people do their best. This is your job. So when they start to understand this, and you start to understand this, then you will see that it does not take that much to pave the way for employees. It does not take that much to increase their will to work. But this is your job. Your job is to understand, how is it that I improve or enhance my team's will to be here? Understand, listen to them. Of course, there are some things that you cannot change, but there are a lot of things that you can change. And just showing your employees that you're actually listening to them, it's a very fantastic first step. Allowing your employees to up-qualify their skills by taking online courses, finding a mentor for them so that they have somebody to speak with if it's not you. These are small things, but have a huge impact to a team, because it shows that you take them seriously. It shows them that you mean what you say, that you walk the talk. That's your job as a leader. Put the people in the will skill matrix. Find out who is in the cannot, will not, and if they can be moved, do whatever you can to move them to will, to can. At the end of the day, if they're unwilling to will work for you, or if they're incapable of up-qualifying their competences, find another place for them. You shouldn't place employees in positions where they do not have the competences or can learn the competences to be a success. That is your job as well. You have to make sure, if you put a person here, he or she must have the competences, otherwise you take all the motivation away, and then you have the will not. So it's a big puzzle to make this work, but this is what you have to think about. You have to think about, are these people actually the right people in the right positions? And changing their positions or their job roles, up-qualifying them, will, in most cases, increasing the will to work and the will to be there. And of course, taking people seriously is also a way of improving people's will to be at work. Another important thing that you have to remember is that sometimes people don't want to work for you or the company. And in these cases, we typically decide to end the relationship 6 to 12 months too late. This will skill matrix will also help fueling that discussion, saying, maybe you're not suited for this company. Maybe you don't really want to work for us. And I find being honest about this is much better for you. It's much better for the employee, because if you decide, no, maybe this is not the right job for me, then you can help them actively find something else, instead of straining it onto the day that it breaks and they have to leave because you've got enough. Be honest, be open. These are people we're dealing with. And I said, above all, you're the leader. It's your responsibility. It's your responsibility to grow the people, to understand which people you want on the team and which people you want to grow and develop and which people you want to help moving on. It's a tough job. It's a hard job. It's a fun job being a leader. Give this one a big like. Make sure that if you haven't done so already, subscribe to the channel. Turn on the gray bell so you get notifications whenever I upload new content. Thanks a lot for watching. Go out there. Be a strong leader. Be the best that you can for your team and your people. Go get them. I'll see you later.